with Mobley, this is somebody every team is dying to have. He reminds me the most of Kevin Garnett of any guy that's coming to the league.
Yo, what is up, guys? It's your boy Jelson here, and today we're back at it with a brand new NBA video. Today's video, we're going to be talking about how I was sleeping on the best rookie in this year's draft class. And that may be a hot take, but I don't think it is, because this man is playing absolutely at an insane level, and that is Evan Mobley. Evan Mobley has been my rookie of the year so far, and honestly, my defensive player of the year so far. And we're talking about a rookie, man. Defensive player of the year is a rookie. That's crazy. And that's really just how good he's been on that side of the ball. And let's talk about that. Let's get into the video and I'll talk more about it. And into that, also, I want to talk about the Cavs team success, because the Cavs have been playing at extremely high levels so far this year, something that I did not expect. So let's start off with Evan Mobley's personal stats. Now, Evan Mobley is averaging about 13.8 points per game, which is, you know, fine for a rookie. It's not elite levels. It's not something we've never seen before, but it's also not bad. He's scoring at a fine level for a rookie, and that's something that we shouldn't be even be scared of, because he showed in college that he could score, and he'll show it again in the big leagues here coming soon, and it's something that he's only going to improve on, so I wouldn't even be scared about it. So I'm actually really excited for Evan Mobley on the offensive side of the ball, but that's not the reason I made this video. The reason I made this video is because how good he's been on defense. On defense, he's averaging about 1.8 block per game, which isn't, you know, something that we've never seen before either, but as a rookie, that probably is. I don't know the exact stat. I said probably because I don't know the exact stat, but it's pretty crazy for a rookie, and that's why I have him as defensive player of the year so far, because you have Mikal Bridges and you have Draymond Green as the two runner-ups in my opinion, and I feel like all three of those, you can kind of flip-flop them and there's no really runaway winner for the defensive player of the year. But I like Evan Mobley because of how much his team has really improved. You know, Draymond Green, yeah, he's been playing well on the defensive side of the ball. We knew he could play well on the defensive side of the ball, and that team's had success in the past. The Cavs, I made a tweet saying that they were going to go 0-82. Obviously, I was exaggerating a little bit and I was just joking, but I was dead serious that they were going to be bad. I thought they were going to be one of the worst teams in the league and end with a top five pick. And I was completely wrong. And it looks like right now they're going to make the playoffs. So a large part of that is Evan Mobley's production on the defense side of the ball. Learning from Jared Allen is a big thing too, because he's one of the better defenders, especially rim protectors in the NBA, along with Rudy Gobert. And I feel like Evan Mobley really does show a lot of that Rudy Gobert type of vibe, where it's like he's going to be a great rim protector to come along here. And I could honestly think that he's going to be better than Rudy Gobert in the future. And he shows more offensive talent than Rudy Gobert has. And I feel like he has just as much defensive potential that Rudy Gobert has ever had. So I don't know if that's a hot take or not, but that's what I at least think. And I'm actually really excited to see what Evan Mobley has to come in the very near future. And don't be surprised when the next two or three, maybe 4 years, when he becomes perennial defensive player of the year, you know, MVP. Okay, maybe I'm, you know, exaggerating a little bit, but you know, I expect him to win at least even one defensive player of the year, you know, coming up here soon. And it really looks like he's going to be one of the better defenders in the league. Actually, he already is, but I would say he's going to be the best defensive player in the league within the next 5 to 10 years, which is something crazy to say, because yeah, I slept on his defense in college, and yeah, I probably am still sleeping on it even though I'm making this video, but he's a great defender, and there's nothing else we can say about it. That team has been one of the best defensive teams in the league, and you know, Evan is one of the players that you can credit towards that. You know, you got Jared Allen, he's a great defender, and then you got Lauri Markkanen, which he's never been known as a great defender, but he's definitely getting better. And when a team has 3 7-footers in their starting lineup on some 2K type stuff, I don't even know what to say, man. And it's working too, obviously, because I'm pretty sure they're a top 4 seed right now, maybe top 5 seed, and they're playing at an extremely high level comparatively to what I thought. And you know, Darius Garland is a big part of that too, and I don't want to forget about him, but Evan Mobley is showing that he's the future of this team, along with, you know, depending on if they sign Colin Sexton back, which I don't think they will, or if they, you know, sign Darius Garland, which is a thing that I definitely think they should do, because he's playing at an extremely high level too this year. And so the Cavs are playing very well, and Evan Mobley, his defense, you know, intensity is nothing to scoff at, and his offensive ability is only going to get better. And right now he's about average on that side of the ball. Obviously for a rookie he's above average for offense, but I'm talking league average, he's about average for offense, and something that I like to see. You know, if a rookie can come in and play great defense and be a at least average offensive player, then that's talking like I would consider it an all-star level player. I would consider him an all-star level player this year, and that may be something that's, you know, a hot take or blasphemy, but I don't think so. This team is playing very well, and he's a big part of the reason they're doing so. And he's, you know, obviously, as I've said, in the defensive player of the year conversation and performing at an average offensive level. If he can increase his scoring just a little bit, I wouldn't be surprised if he's an all-star this year or maybe even next year. So we'll see what happens. I doubt he'll win all-star, or, you know, be an all-star, I should say, but it's just because he's a rookie, and that's stuff that happens. And he's also in the Cavs, and that's not even, no disrespect to the Cavaliers as a team, it's just they're a small market, and a lot of people don't pay attention to the Cavaliers, even though they should. They're playing extremely well this year, which is so, so great for them, and I'm kind of jealous as a Timberwolves fan, because our team has been kind of mid without D'Angelo Russell. But anyway, this Cavaliers team is improving year by year, and they're showing it. One of the players that I felt like was going to be great this year but wasn't is Chetty Osman. He's been kind of average, if not below average. He's kind of a bad shooter, and he's not a great finisher either, and his defense is solid, but it's not great. It's just feels like he's such a below average player, and I feel like he was going to be a lot better than that, like a six man of the year type of player, but turns out he's really not. And Chetty Osman needs to be benched, or I mean, I guess he already is, but you know what I mean. He needs less minutes than he's getting, and I feel like if they get one more piece, he's going to be the guy to go. And that may be a hot take too, but I just think he's not good at all. But obviously, we'll see what happens. But that's my video on Evan Mobley and the Cavaliers. I feel like they're going to be really good soon. And, well, I mean, technically, they're already really good, but I feel like they're going to be really good, like, championship contenders as long as their players can keep developing very, very soon. And, yeah, guys, if you guys did enjoy this video, remember, like, subscribe. It's been your boy, Jelson. We're on that road to 500 subscribers. I got a new mic, so if you guys do enjoy that, please let me know, because, you know, I'm still trying to get used to it. So, if the audio is a little weird, I'm doing some editing with the audio, and that's why. But if you guys did enjoy, as I said, please remember, like, subscribe, share it with your friends, because we are trying to hit 500 subscribers. And yeah, guys, see you guys next time. Peace out.